I'm Matt, your host for 76 Seconds of History, and today we're talking about one of the world's most famous paintings, Washington Crossing the Delaware. Now, it's a beautiful painting, but it makes you wonder, did the crossing really look like that? Let's break it down. The painting was created in 1851 by a German artist named Emanuel Leutze. Since he wasn't alive for the crossing, it makes sense that he took some liberties in the painting. For instance, Leutze depicts a dawn crossing, but it really happened in the middle of the night, during a blizzard. The boat is a lot smaller than the actual Durham boats that were used in the crossing, and this flag wasn't created until about a year after the crossing. When it comes to the general himself, Leutze's version of Washington has too many gray hairs. George was only 44 years old in 1776. Look closely and you'll see future President James Monroe holding the flag behind George Washington. One small problem, it's the wrong Washington. Monroe crossed with his commander, William Washington, of the 3rd Virginia Regiment. Inaccuracies aside, the painting was intended to spur patriotism in the United States, and it has. Visitors to Washington Crossing Historic Park love viewing the full-size replica inside the visitor center. Thanks for joining us for 76 Seconds of History here at Washington Crossing Historic Park. We hope to see you soon.